Hi guys, in this video we are going to discuss problem climbing the leaderboard. So in this problem, see this is a problem from the HackerRank, and in this problem it is given that Elias is playing a arcade game and wants to climb the top of the leaderboard and wants to track her ranking, and the game uses dense ranking. So now the conditions for the ranking in this game is the player with the highest score is ranked number 1 on the leaderboard. So it means that the player which have the highest score will be ranked 1, and the player who have equal scores will receive same ranking number. So it means that there are two players who scored 100, so both of them will be ranked same. So let's say if the rank of this player is X, then the rank of this player should also be X. Let's say this is player P1 and this is player P2, and the next player receive the immediately following ranking number. So now let's say the scores are integers in this game. So let's say if there is a next player who scored 99, so the rank of that player should be X plus 1. It doesn't matter that there are two players with the same rank. The next player would be ranked the next rank immediately. So now in this problem, we will be given an array of leaderboard and an array of scores scored by the allies, and we have to told her rank according to that score. So now let's understand an example. So let's say in this example, this is the leaderboard or the score of the leaderboard of the all the other players, and this is the array of scores scored by the allies in different trials. So let's say in the first trial she scored 5, in the next trial she scored 25, but she want to know her ranking according to a particular score. So now first of all, let's calculate the rank of the scores present in the leaderboard. So since this 100 is the highest score in the leaderboard, so the player with this score will be ranked 1, and since there are two players with the same score, so they will be ranked same. Now the next player has score 50, so it would be ranked 2. Another player would be ranked 3. Since these two scores are same, so the score of this player would also be 3, and the rank with score 20 would be 4, and with 10 it would be 5. Now Elias want to know if she score 5, then what would be its rank. So if we want to calculate her rank when she scored 5, so what we can do is, in brute force manner, we can add this 5 in this array and sort again this array if it becomes unsorted, and then we will calculate her rank. So let's say if we inserted this 5 in this sorted array, then we will add this 5 at the last of this array because 10 is greater than 5. Now the rank of allies would be 6, because after 5 the next rank would be 6. So we can say that if she score 5, then the rank of allies would be 6. Now similarly, for the next score, if she score 25, then we have to add this 25 in this leaderboard. So we can add this 25 here only, because 25 is less than 40 and greater than 20. So 25 would be added here, and now the new ranking in this leaderboard would be, till 40 it would remain same because we have not changed any value before 40. So now the rank of this 25, or the rank of the player who scored 25, would be 4, and further it would be 5 and then 6. So at this point Elias would ranked at 4. Now in the next case, she's saying that she scored 50. So now if she score 50, it means that her score would lie at this interval. So here we will add 50, and again we will sort this array. So and after sorting we will get this position of 50, and now the new ranking of allies would be 2 only, because there is also a 50 present in this leaderboard and who ranked 2. So the ranking of allies would also be 2. So in this scenario allies would be ranked 2. And now finally she is saying that she scored 120. So since 120 is greater than all the scores present in the header would. So it means that this 120 would come at index 0 after sorting this array and inserting this 120 in the given array. So at this point, the ranking of Alice would be 1 now. So at with score 120, her ranking would be 1. So we have to return this ranking array as an answer, which means that we have to return the array of ranking to Alice, that these would be the rank if she scored these scores. So now to find her ranking, what we can do is, in a brute force manner or brute force approach, what we can do is we can insert that element in the given array, then we can sort that array, and in the O(n) time complexity we can calculate the rank. And since we have to calculate multiple ranks, so the overall time complexity for this approach could be m into n. And since the sorting would take n log n time, so even we can say that m into n into log n. And if some pre-computation are done, then overall time complexity for the brute force approach could be till m into n only. So in this video, we are going to see an approach in which we can solve this problem in big O of m into log n time complexity. So now to solve this problem in big O of m into log n time complexity, we can say that to find the new ranking, what we can do is, I'm going to tell you the intuitive idea behind solving this problem, is to find the rating of Alice or the ranking of Alice, what we can do is we can find just greater element in the given array. Or present in the leaderboard array. And after finding that element, we can say that if that element or this just greater element could also be equal to the given element, like to the given score of the Alice, and if that element is equal to the just greater element, or if we could found a Alice score which is also present in the leaderboard score, then we can say that the rank for that score of Alice would be same as the rank of that element present in the leaderboard. So at that time, rank would be same. And otherwise, if that element which is found in the leaderboard array is just greater than the element or for which we are calculating the rank of the Alice score, in that case we can say that the rank of Alice would be rank of that score plus 1, because here we can see that if we are calculating the rank for the score 25, then this 25 would definitely will come after 20. And since insertion of this 25 in this leaderboard array does not affect the prefix array, so it means that the rank of 20 would remain as it is. And since this 25 is added just after this 20, so we can say that the rank of this 25 would be 1 greater than the rank of this 20, which is just greater element. Or sorry, this not this 25, this 25 would be added here. So here we can say that the prefix array is not disturbed at all, and the rank of this 40, which is 3 here, since the rank of this 40 is 3, before insertion is 25 and after insertion of 25 also, and the rank of this 25 can be calculated as the rank of 40 plus 1, which is 3 plus 1, which is equals to 4. And now to find the just greater element present in this given array, we can use binary search. Because by using binary search, it would give the result in log n time complexity. We can say that if we want to find the rank for 25, so we will get this 40 as our just greater element, and we can store a map which will map the initial leaderboard to the initial ranking. So let's say we will store a map which will store the mapping of the scores with its rank. So in that map we will store 100 corresponding to 1, 50 has rank 2, 40 has rank 3, 20 has rank 4, and 10 has rank 5. So now if you want to calculate the rank of, let's say, 25, so we will give call to our binary search to find the just greater element, and it says that the just greater element is 40. So now using this map, we will get the ranking or the rank of the player with score 40, which is here coming out to be 3. So we can say that since this 40 is just greater than 25, so the ranking, so the rank of allies with score 25 would be 3. And if we say that we have to find the rank of 50, so we can say that we will give call to the binary search to find the just greater element, or it could be equal also, so it will also return 50 to us. And now we can say that we will find the rank of this 50 from our map, which is 2 here, and then we can say that since this 50 is equal to the just greater element, so the rank of allies would be 2. Now the main thing is with this this score, which is 120. So now if we say that allies scored 120, so now this 120 is actually the greatest element from all the elements present in this given array. So to avoid any runtime error in our binary search, what we will do is we will make a new array in which we will insert maximum value of integer at the index 0 and minimum, which is score 0, at the last index. And we can say that the rank of this maximum would be 0, and the rank of this 0 is the rank of this 10 plus 1. So let's say rank of 10 plus 1. So now in this case, if we want to find the rank of 120, so we can say that this 120 will definitely lie at this interval, because this maximum is greater than 120 and this 10 is less than 120. So this 120 will lie at this position, and our binary search will return the value of just greater as max. So now we will get max as our just greater element, and in the mapping also we will insert this max with rank 0 and score 0 with rank 6, which is 10 plus 1. Now we can say that we have to find the rank of 120, so we get max from the binary search. Now we will get the rank of this max, which is 0, because it is we can say it is acting as a base case to avoid the runtime error. So we can say that the rating of our element, which is 120, is the rank of max plus 1, which is 1. So now this case is also handled, which is a corner case actually. And let's say if we want to get the rank of this 5, so in case of 5 also we can say that this 5 would be inserted between this 0 and 10, and to find the rank of 5 we will give call to the binary search to find the just greater element, which will come out to be 10, and the rank of 10 is 5, so the rank of our element would be 5 plus 1, which is 6. So here we can say that there is no need to insert 0 here, but it would be better if we insert to avoid any runtime error. But inserting this maximum element is a must, because what we are doing is we are calculating just greater element, and if there is no just greater element, then it could return minus 1 or something else. So we have to handle that case. So instead of handling a case with mid equal to minus 1, so it would be better if we insert a maximum element at the index 0, so that we would get a maximum or a just greater element every time. So the basic algorithm to solve this problem is, since we can say that this problem is reduced to find just the just greater element, because if we are able to calculate this just greater element, then we can directly calculate the rank by using our map. So here I have written the algorithm to calculate the just greater element. So now here what I am doing is I have initialized this low as 0 and high as n minus 1, which is the last index, and initially I have set the just greater element as 0. So now then we will calculate the mid, which is low plus high by 2. And now let's say the target is the current score of allies, so we can say that this target is equals to score. So now after getting this score, we will check if this target is equals to array of mid. It means that we are going to find the rank of 50, and we found this 50 in the leaderboard also. So just from here I have returned this just greater element as target and break from this position. And if this target is less than array of mid, so what does it means that let's say we are standing at element 100 and our mid is pointing at 100 and we have element 50. So it means that our target value is less than this mid and we have to find the just greater element, which is just greater than this 50. So it means that since this array is this leaderboard array is sorted, so to find the just greater element than 50, we have to move our search space to the right side, because in the left side all the elements would be greater than 50 only. Because this 100 is greater than 50, it means that all the elements in the left side would also be greater than 50. So it means that we have to take our search space to the right side. So here what we are doing is we have changed our low as mid plus 1, and in the final case, if let's say there is element 20 and our mid is pointing to 20 and the target value is 50, so it means that at this position the element is smaller than the target value, so it could not be the largest or just larger element than 50, and on the right side all the elements would be smaller than 50, so we have to take our search space to the right side, to the left side. So in this case I have changed our high as mid minus 1. It means that we have given call to the left side to calculate the just greater element, and after calculating this element we can check that if our target value is equals to just greater element, it means that the rank of our target is equals to the rank of just greater element, and otherwise the rank of our target element would be equal to rank of just greater element plus 1. So in this way we can get the rank for any target value or the any score of the allies in log n time complexity. And let's say if we have to solve m queries, then we can solve this problem in m log n time complexity. Thank you guys.